Hello friends, welcome you all to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss about a very important aspect of plant taxonomy, and that is the Bentham and Hooker system of plant classification. We will learn this classification into the two parts. In part first, we'll study about a very brief life history of Bentham and Hooker, their key point of classification, then the general outline of their classification and the detailed account of their classification up to the subclass Monoclimidae. So let's start with a brief introduction of Bentham and Hooker. So Bentham, George Bentham, who studied the law and philosophy, but later on he shows a very keen interest in the field of plant sciences, and due to which he traveled extensively in a different region of the country and collected several plant specimens. He studied all these plant specimens in a detail, and later on he deposited all these plant specimens as a herbarium sheet at the herbarium of Royal Botanical Garden, Kew. Then Bentham wrote a very famous handbook known as British Flora, which is published in the year of 1858, which is still used as a guide for the naming of plant specimens by a new plant taxonomist. Then he was a president of Linnaean Society from the year of 1861 to 1874, and he was also elected as a fellow of the Royal Society in the year of 1864. So this is a very brief about the life history of George Bentham. Then Sir Joseph Dalton Hooker. Apart from a very famous scientist, Sir Joseph Dalton Hooker is also remembered as one of the closest friends of Charles Darwin, who proposed the theories of evolution. Now Hooker was appointed as an assistant director of Royal Botanical Garden in the year of 1855, and later on he is acting as a director from 1865 and 20 years as a director of Royal Botanical Garden, Kew. Then Hooker also wrote a number of scientific papers, monographs and a books, out of which The Flora of British India, which he published into the 7 volume, it is a very famous book which is used by a emerging plant taxonomist. So this is all about a very brief life history of Bentham and Hooker. Now these are some key features or the highlights of their classification. Now the Bentham and Hooker system of plant classification, it is supposed to be the best example of natural system of plant classification. So there are various types of plant classification, such as artificial, natural and phylogenetic, out of which this particular system belongs from the natural system of plant classification. Now what is meant by natural system of plant classification? So those classifications in which the several naturally occurring taxonomy characters are considered for the grouping of plants. Okay, so such type of plant classification is called as natural system of plant classification. Okay, what is natural system of plant classification? So in this type of classification, a several naturally occurring taxonomic characters are considered for the grouping or differentiation in a different taxa. So such type of plant classification is called as natural system of plant classification. And the Bentham and Hooker system, it is the best example of natural system of plant classification. So this Bentham and Hooker, they published their plant classification in the book Genera Plantarum into the three volumes in between the year 1862 to 1883. So in this period, they published three volumes of Genera Plantarum in which they proposed their system of plant classification. So for their classification, the Bentham and Hooker studied 97,205 plant specimens. They studied actual plant specimen belongs from the 7,569 genera. Okay, so such huge number of plant specimens they studied for their classification. So these species they divided into the 202 families. Now they are considered as order, but at that time they considered the families. So all the species they divided into the 202 families, out of which 199 families are belongs from the angiosperms, and the three remaining families they belong from the gymnosperms. So this is all about the key features or the highlights of the Bentham and Hooker system of plant classification. So this is the general outline. This is the general outline of Bentham and Hooker system of plant classification. So he divided, or they divided, the complete plant kingdom into the two divisions, that is cryptogams and the phenograms. The division phenograms is further divided into the three classes, that is dicotyledons, gymnospermy and the monocotyledons. Then dicot also divided into the three subclasses, that is polypetiole, gamopetiole and monoclymidae. Now each subclass is divided further into the different series. For example, the subclass polypetiole divided into the thalamiflora, riciflora and the calyciflora. They are the three series. In the same way, gamopetiole divided into the inferi, heteromeri and the bicarpellate. Then monoclymidae divided into the coroembric, multiolati aquaticae, multiolati terrestris, microembry, daphnels, acclimatospori, unisexuals and the ornis animali. So all these series belong from the class dicotyledons. Then the class gymnosperm is directly divided into the series, that is Nietzschei, coniferi and the cycadaceae. While monocots, it is divided into the microspermi, epigyni, coronary, calycini, nodiflora, apocarpi and the glumaceae. So this is a outline. This is the outline of Bentham and Hooker system of plant classification. Now we'll talk about in detail up to the subclass monoclymidae. Okay, we talk about the subclass up to the monoclymidae in a detail. So the plant kingdom is divided into the two divisions, that is cryptogams and the phenograms. It is also called as cryptophyta. Cryptogams is also called as cryptophyta, and the phenograms is also called as spermatophyta. Now these two divisions are divided on the basis of whether the plant consists a flower and seed. Okay, so those plants which doesn't bear the flowers means non-flowering and non-sedate, all these plants are grouped under the division cryptogams. This group consists of those plants which doesn't bear the flower, means flower is absent and the seed is absent. So all these plants are grouped under the division cryptogams, while those plants which bears flower, flowering plants, and seed bearing plants, means those plants which consist of flower and seed, they are grouped under the division phenograms or spermatophyta. So they are the two important characters on the basis of which the plant kingdom is divided into the two divisions, cryptogams and the phenograms. Now the division phenograms is further divided into the three classes. that is class dicotyledons, gymnospermy and the monocotyledons. They are the three classes of phanerogams. Now the dicotyledons are characterized by the presence of two cotyledons, reticulate venation, taproot, and the flower is pentamerous. So these are the characters of class dicotyledons. Means the seed consists of two number of cotyledons are present. Then the venation pattern is reticulate, means leaves shows reticulate type of venation pattern, means from a single midrib a number of secondary veins or arises which again branch and form a network like structure into the leaf lamina, that is called as reticulate type of venation. Then the taproot system, means the main root system which is developed from the radical, and the flower is pentamerous. It means the floral valves are in a multiple of 5, means the calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. These floral valves are in a multiple of 5. It means 5 calyx, 5 petals, 5 stamens and so on. So such type of flower is called as pentamerous flower. So those plants which shows all these characters, they are grouped under the class dicotyledons. Then the class gymnospermy. So this class is categorized by the presence of naked ovule and the typical flower is absent. Okay, naked ovule and the typical flower is absent. Naked ovule, it means the ovule is not enclosed inside the ovary. As we seen in angiosperms, the angiosperm consists of all the whatever the ovules are there, they are grouped or they are covered inside the ovary. So such type of ovules are not present in the gymnosperms, and that's why they are called as naked. They are called as naked ovules. And other character, that is the flower is absent. A typical flower, as we talk about this, typical flower means they shows calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Okay, so such type of whorls is absent in the plants. So those plants which shows these characters are grouped under the class gymnospermy. And lastly, that is monocotyledons, which are characterized by the presence of single or one cotyledon, parallel venation, adventitious root and trimerous flower. It means the seed consists of single cotyledon, leaves consist of parallel venation. Okay, means more than two veins arises from the petiole and they run parallel in the leaf lamina. Okay, they run parallel to each other along in the leaf lamina. So such type of venation is called as parallel venation. Then the adventitious type of root, apart from the radical, the roots are also developed from the other parts of the plants. Such type of conditions occur in the monocots and the flower is trimerous. Trimerous means calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. They are in a multiple of 3, means three stamens, three calyx, three corolla, three carpels, it takes long. Okay, so such type of flower is called as trimerous flower. So those plants which shows all these characters, they are considered or they are grouped under the class monocotyledons. Okay, so there are the three classes of division phanerogams. Okay, now these classes are again further divided into the subclasses. Now first of all, we talk about the subclass polypetiole. Okay, that is dicotyledons again divided into the three subclasses, that is polypetiole, gamopetiole and the monoclymatic. These are the three subclasses of class dicotyledons. Now the subclass polypetiole, it is characterized by the presence of free or separate petals. Okay, means the corolla which shows free or separate petals. Corolla, that is called as, that is collective form, and the individual member of corolla, that is called as a petals. Okay, the individual member of corolla, that is called as petals. So those flowers which consist of free or separate petals, or they are slightly united at the base. Okay, so such type of flower or such type of plants are grouped under the subclass polypetiole. Okay, where the flower consists of free or separate corolla. Okay, the petals are free from each other. So such characters or such type of plants which shows this character, it is considered under the subclass Polypetalin. Then the subclass Gamopetalin. Gamo, that is united, petali, that is petal, means those plants which having fused or united corolla. Okay, means those flowers in which the petals are fused or they are united. Such type of condition are considered under the subclass Gamopetali. Means flowers with fused and united petals. Such type of plants are considered under the subclass Gamopetali. While the Monoclimaty are those plants which doesn't bear the corolla. Means corolla is absent. It means instead of that, the perianth members are present. Instead of corolla, the perianth members are present. Okay. So those plants which bears the perianth members, they are considered under the subclass Monoclimaty. Okay. So they are the three subclass of class Dicotyledons. Now again, these subclasses are grouped or they are divided into the different ranks or taxa. Now first of all, you talk about the subclass Polypetalin. Now this subclass Polypetalin again consists of three series. They are divided into the three series, that is series Thalamiflori, Dicyflori and the Calyciflori. They are the three series of subclass Polypetalin. Now you talk about what are the characters of Thalamiflori. Okay. Now the Thalamiflori, it is characterized by the presence of a distinct thalamus. The flower consists of distinct thalamus, then the stamens are numerous, flower is hypogynous. Flower is all hypogynous. Okay, so that the important characters to identify the Thalamiflori. That is, first of all, a distinct thalamus is there, then the stamens are numerous or they are more number, then the flower is hypogynous. What is the hypogynous? Hypogynous flower is means the calyx, corolla and androecium, they develop from the base of the ovary. Okay, the flower in which the calyx, corolla and androecium, if they develop, if they arise from the base of the ovary, that type of flower is called as hypogynous flower. Okay, so the series Thalamiflori is characterized by this such type of flower, and the disc is absent below the ovary. Generally in certain plants a disc like structure is present below the ovary. Okay, so such type of structure is absent in the Thalamiflori. So those plants which shows such type of characters, they are grouped under the series Thalamiflori. Then the series Dicyflori. So as name indicate, Dicy means a disc is present. Okay, the gynoecium consists of what? A disc. A disc is present below the ovary. Then the flower is hypogynous. The flower is hypogynous and the disc-like structure is present below the ovary. So such characters signifies the series Dicyflori. Okay. And lastly, the series Calyciflori. Now the Calyciflori, it is characterized by the presence of peri or epigynous. They are characterized by the presence of perigynous or epigynous flower, and the ovary is what? It is inferior. In both series, the ovary is superior, but in Calyciflori, the ovary is what? The ovary is inferior in nature. Now, why it is inferior? Because the flower is either perigynous or either epigynous. Now, what is perigynous and epigynous? Now, what is perigynous? So, in this type of flower, the ovary is get embedded into the thalamus. It get inserted or it get embedded inside the thalamus, and due to which the calyx, corolla, androecium, it looks like that they are developed from the middle part. They are developed from the middle part of the ovary. So such type of flower is called as perigynous flower, or it may be epigynous. It means the calyx, corolla and androecium, they develop from the top of the ovary. Okay, so such type of flower is called as epigynous flower. Okay, so such type of characters, they signifies the series Calyciflori. Okay, so there are the three series of subclass Polypetalin. Now each series is further divided into the orders and family. If you talk about the series Thalamiflori, It is divided into the 6 orders and 34 families. Then the Disciplinary, it is divided into the 4 orders and 22 families, and the Calliciflora, it is divided into the 5 orders and 27 families. So this is all about the subclass Polypetali. Then the subclass Gamopetali. Okay. Then the subclass Gamopetali is also divided into the 3 series. Okay. It is also divided into the 3 series. That is series Inferi, Heteromeri, and the Bicarpellate. Now the Inferi series consists of those plants which having epigynous flower and the ovaries are inferior. Means petals are, they are fused, gamopetali, that is petals are fused, flower is epigynous and the ovaries inferior. So such type of characters are those plants which show such type of characters, they are grouped under the series Inferi. Okay. So this Inferi can consist of 3 orders and the 9 families. Then the series Heteromeri. Now Heteromeri, it is characterized by the presence of superior ovary. Okay, the flower having a superior ovary because the flower is hypogynous in nature, due to which the ovary is superior. Then the androecium are present into the one or more valves. Okay, they are present in a one or more valves. Okay, means they are in a series. Outer and the inner staminal series are there. They are in a valves. And the carpels are also more than 2. More than 2 carpels. Then the androecium, they are in a one or more series. Flower is hypogynous and the ovary is superior. So those plants which show such type of characters, they are grouped under the series Heteromeri. Okay. Now this series also consists of 3 orders and 12 families. And lastly, the series Bicarpellate. Now as the name indicates, that is Bicarpellate. Bi means 2, carpellate it means carpels. Means those plants which consist of superior ovary and 2 carpels. They are consist of 2 carpels, ovary superior, flower is hypogynous, and the androecium is in a single series. It only one valve is there of androecium, or it only single series is there. Then the 2 united carpels, ovary is superior and the flower is hypogynous. Okay. So such type of characters are present, or they are signifies the series Bicarpellate. Now this Bicarpellate is again divided into the 4 orders and the 23 families. So this is all about the subclass Gamopetali. Then the subclass Monoclamadi. So the subclass Monoclamadi, it consists of 8 series. Monoclamadi, it means the perianth members are present. Corolla is totally absent, and instead of that, the perianth members are present in the subclass Monoclamadi, which is further divided into the 8 series. Now the first series, that is curved embry. So as name indicates, curved embry. Curved, that is means coiled or curved. Embry, that is embryo. Means those plants which is having a single ovule, and the embryo of the ovule, it is what? It is curved or it is coiled. So such plants are grouped under the series curved embry. This series also consists of 6 family. Okay, it consists of all the 6 families. Then the series Multiovulati Aquaticae. So as name indicates, multiovulati, it means the plant consists of multiple or numerous ovules, and they are aquatic in nature. Okay, the numerous ovules are there, and the plants are aquatic in habitat. Means they are found or they are grow in a water. So that's why it is called as aquatic plants. So such plants which grows in a water and bears a multiple or numerous ovules, such plants are grouped under the series Multiovulati Aquaticae. So this series consists of only single family. Then the series Multiovulati Terrestris. Okay, here also, as name indicates, multiovulati, it means multiple or numerous ovules. Terrestris, It means the plants are terrestrial in habitat. Okay, plants are terrestrial in habitat means they grow on a land and they having a multiple or numerous ovules. Okay, so such type of plants which bear such type of characters, so these plants are included under the series multi-ovulating terrestries. So this consists of three families. This series consists of three families. Then the next series, that is microembryonic. Micro, that is means small. Embry means that is embryo. Means those plants which is having very small or minute embryo. Okay, in those plants which consist of a very small or minute embryo, perianth members. These plants are included under the series microembry. Okay, so this series also consists of four families. Okay, then the next series, that is the series Daphnales. Okay, series Daphnales. Now this series is characterized by the presence of monocarpellary ovary. Means the ovary consists of single carpel. It consists of a single carpel. That why it is called as monocarpellary. And the ovary consists of single ovule. Okay, single carpel, single ovule. Okay, so such type of characters are present in the series Daphnales. Okay, single or monocarpellary ovary which consists of a single ovule. That is the characters of the series Daphnales, which further consists of five families. Then the series Oclamadosporin. Now this series is characterized by the presence of a single locule. Single locule, inferior ovary with few ovules. Okay, single locula, unilocula, inferior ovary with few ovules. Single locular it means, or unilocular it means, when you take the section of an ovary, when you take the TS of ovary, the ovary shows a single compartment. Only single compartment is there, single chamber is there. Such type of ovary is called as unilocular, unilocular or one locular. Then the ovary, it is inferior. It means the flower is either perigynous or either epigynous. Okay, so that's why ovary is what? It is inferior. And the ovary is with 2 to 3 ovules. Few ovules are there. Okay, so such characters are characterized or they are signified by the series Oclamadospori. Okay, so this series consists of three families. Then the series Unisexuals. Okay, so as again name indicates, unisexuals means only one sexual valves. Okay, means the flower consists of only one sexual valve. The flowers are unisexual. Flowers are what? Unisexual. It means the flower consists of only one sexual valve. It may be androecium or it may be gynoecium. It may be male flower or it may be female flower. Okay, so that type of flower is consist of what? That is called as unisexual. Either male flower or either female flower, or either consist of androecium or either gynoecium. Okay, such flower are also called as the staminate and the pistillate. Male flower is also called as staminate flower, and the female flower is also called as pistillate flower. Okay, so such type of flowers consist in those plants. So and that plants are, they are included under the series unisexuals, which is further consist of 9 families. Okay, and lastly the series Ornis anomaly. Series Ornis anomaly means their position, it is anomalous. Those plants which having the anomalous position, they having uncertain relationship, means these plants having what? Uncertain relationship with each other, or as compared to the other taxa, their position is anomalous. Uncertain position is there. Okay, for example, the family Ceratophyllaceae, the member of Ceratophyllaceae, they having a uncertain position. They are having a anomalous characteristics. Okay, so such type of families or such type of plants, they are included under the series Ornis anomaly, which again consists of a 9 families. Okay, so this is all about the 8 series of Monoclimadia. Okay, so in this way, In this video, we studied about the class dicotyledons, okay, class dicotyledons in detail. That is, dicots consist of three subclasses, that is polypetaly, gamopetaly, and the monoclamidy. So this is a detailed account of the taxa present in a class dicotyledons. So in next video, we'll talk about the remaining portion of the Bentham and Hooker system of plant classification, that is about the class Gymnospermae and the monoclamidy. Thank you.